Hello, hello, everybody. I just wanted to come on today because I need to do my makeup for a video that I'm doing, not a live video. And I thought I would just do some makeup live, and then because I need a full face of makeup for my video, but I'm just going to showcase the lipstick. So I thought I'd just come on and do a full face of makeup with you guys. Why not, right? So I'm going to start. Hi, Cindy. How are you? I just thought I would do some more bougier makeup today, because I'm going to do a video later and I need a full face of makeup. So I'm just starting with my VFX Pro Camera Ready Primer. I tried to get my light together today, guys, because my lighting, I feel like, is not good. But where I sit, there is a huge window here and a huge window here, so I think sometimes it just competes with the light on my thing that holds my phone here. So I'm just priming, and I was outside most of the morning with my kids, so I really got some sun here. I hope everybody's having a good Sunday. Just trying to do catch up and get everything ready for the week today. That's what I'm doing. Laundry, all that fun stuff. I'm just gonna let this dry. This is supposed to dry before you continue on with your next step. It's my new cup I bought myself. It says motherhood, powered by love, fueled by coffee, sustained by wine. It couldn't have been more true for me, but now I just have lemon water in it. So anyway, I'm gonna get started. So that was the primer that I put on. And I am gonna do a little bit of concealer. I feel like I'm not doing too bad with my under eye bags and all that right now. So I'm not gonna do a ton of concealer. I am gonna do this, and just right inside here, I do have some darkness, but directly under my eyes, I'm gonna try not to do a bunch of concealer under there, just because I've said it before, I'm wrinkly and it just sits in those wrinkles there. And so I don't need that. I don't need anything that's going to enhance those wrinkles. So I am gonna take that up a little bit, and then just under right here, not directly under my eye though, because like I said, I do not want anything that's gonna sit in those creases. And I like to do my concealer with my fingers most of the time. So that's what I'm doing. Moving it down this way and then back up. All right, so that is that. And then I'm gonna do some VFX Pro Camera Ready foundation. This is the O2. And I'm gonna put this on the back of my hand here and just use my Farmasi brush here, which I really just recently started using, and I really like it. I'm tapping just all over. You guys remember this song? My ear. This might be a little dark for me, this shade. Even with my tan I have going on, a little bit of a tan. but we'll blend. You won't notice. And I always manage to get all this stuff in my hair. I don't know if I did or not. Then I'm gonna drag all this down because I definitely don't want any lines. If you're like me and you love a good makeup brush, this is really a nice brush. Hi, Angie! Thank you for watching! So, I'm just doing some VFX Pro right now. I have the O2, which is natural beige. And I'm pretty fair complexion. I have a pretty fair complexion, so I'm hoping this might get me through even the summer with a tan. We'll see. You love this brush too, Cindy? It's so nice. And then we have the concealer one. I love these. They're so soft. And they just blend really well. So anyway, that's that. I'm having like a Texas hair moment today or something, like big Texas hair. I don't even know what's going on with it today. I mean, I'm not mad about it, but big. Hi, Kayla! Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I forgot to put jewelry on today. I'll put it on later. All right, so that was that. So I've done my concealer, my Camera Ready primer. Hi, Ollie. And my VFX Pro foundation. And so today I'm going to work with mostly the Iconic palette because I love it. Kayla, they are. Those brushes are amazing. And I had them for a while and just now started using them because I don't know why I do that, but I do. I am going to use the one color from the Glam Up palette just because I really love this for a base, this Dusty Rose. It's my favorite. So I'm just going to go on my eye and just do my whole entire eye with that, all the way up. That just really gives me a good base for the other colors that I'm going to add. And if you don't have both of these palettes, you absolutely do not have to do this step. You could put anything on, you could do nothing. I just like this just for a little base, that's all. And this Dusty Rose, I could wear just by itself. It's so pretty. Hi, Libby. So that's that. That's all I'm doing from the Glam Up palette. I think that it really is easier to apply the foundation. And look how smooth. And the coverage is just great with those brushes. They're very, very nice. Okay, so what I'm going to do next, I have my Iconic palette here, which I think has just such pretty colors in it. And it's funny because I've said this before, when I first saw this Iconic palette, I think these two colors threw me off. Like, I don't know if I would use them, but look at all the other ones. They are just like right up my alley. So I'm really glad that I ended up getting all of them. I snatched up all these palettes when they had a fire sale, I think, or something Farmasi did. So anyway, I'm gonna do this Bliss, and if you guys have watched any of my other videos, I like to match my makeup with my clothes. I don't know why, I just always do that. So I'm going in with the Bliss, and I'm gonna use this as my transition color. And what I mean by that is I am gonna just start here and do a little swirl, and it's a little dark, darker than I would normally do, but like I said, bougie today. I'm just going to swirl and then windshield wiper. And what you do when you do that is you really get a lot of your product here in the corner where I want the depth, but then you still can get some and a lighter version of it across your eye, which is exactly what I want to do. So swirl, swipe. Like that. And I intentionally went a little higher there, you can see. And we'll blend that in later, but I did intentionally do that because I really want this color to show right there in that crease. So that's what I'm doing. And then just windshield wiping. Like I said, I'm doing that extra on the end intentionally because I am trying to be a little extra today with my makeup. Okay. So there's that, and that's just the Bliss, which is here. And then I am gonna do another color that's just, it's also dark, but like I said, we're extra today. I'm gonna move next to that with this Struggle, the Struggle Bus. And I am gonna take just a more tightly packed brush like this for the Struggle because I really don't want a lot of this because this is dark, but I do wanna emphasize just this spot right here again. Just like a little bit in that V. And I'm not taking it all the way across my eye like I did that other color. I am gonna just do here and maybe tiny bit, but not across my whole eye because I don't want all that darkness across my whole eye. I'm just really trying to get it in this little spot here, my little that I'm trying to get with here. This is the first time I'm using these colors together, so we'll see. Same thing over here, just in the corner and then up on that spot that I'm trying to emphasize to do like a cat eye without doing an eyeliner cat eye because also if you've watched my videos, you know your girl can't do that either. I've tried all the tricks. I've taped everything. It just doesn't work. So we've moved on from that. It sounds like I haven't, but I have. Okay. So then, I am going to now go in with Myth, which is so pretty. This color right here, dark, dark, dark. And I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm actually going to just use that same brush. And this Myth has a sparkle. So the other ones so far have been, what's the word I'm looking for? No sparkle. So the Myth does have a little sparkle, and I'm just going to kind of do the same thing. I'm just trying to build this color right here. Thank you, Kayla Matt. Jeez Louise. A matte. The other colors so far have been mattes. What would I do without you girls? And this has a sparkle to it. So you can kind of see where I'm headed with that. It's definitely, I'm hoping to give me kind of a lift where I feel like I need it. And one eye always looks better than the other. I feel like this eye is looking way better than that other eye. But my favorite thing to do is blend and then it all comes together. So then, this is what I've been waiting for. Oh, look at this mermaid, guys. Look how pretty that color is. The mermaid. Right, matte or shimmer. I could not think of the word matte. So I like to do my shimmer with my finger and just tap. I'm throwing it back with some of this music I got going today, guys, which I love. And I don't own the rights to this music, Facebook. I put it in my comments up there, so let your girl live. Because out of everybody, I feel like I constantly get shut down on Facebook for this music, and I'm always letting them know I don't own the rights. I ain't Salt or Peppa. So then that sparkle. Hi, Krista! Thank you for watching. All right, so then I am gonna do a tiny bit of that highlight up here. Let's use this brush. Just a tiny bit of that mermaid, because she is so pretty. And then what I have to do, I like to go in with a brush that has nothing on it and just kind of do some blending. And you really could. I could go back in with a little bit of this dusty rose and blend a little bit. Because it really does just bring everything together nicely. But you don't have to. You can just do like a brush with nothing on it. And it really will marry all the colors together very, very nicely. So just kind of like that. I love those colors. I am definitely a bronzy, mauvey. I love me some bronze. All right, so I'm also gonna use this Extra Last eye pencil. I have always been a liquid liner gal, always. And I think it's because I love, right, Cindy, you get shut down. They are tripping. Facebook is really tripping because, you know, and I made a post earlier today about it because I see so much nastiness and hate on Facebook, and it really makes my heart so sad for people that cannot just scroll past something that they don't agree with or they don't like, and they have to make a nasty, rude, hateful comment. Like, did that really make you feel better? Because I feel like if that made you feel better, you should look inward instead of projecting. But my sister gave me this sticker the other day. And I know it's backwards, but it says grace changes everything. And as I was scrolling through Facebook today, I was just seeing some of the most hateful stuff, and I made a post about it. And because grace really does change everything. And am I? You got kicked off too, Kayla? They're out of their mind. But I did. And you know, am I perfect? No. Have I, you know, been judgy when maybe I should have shown somebody a little more grace? Absolutely. I'm human, you know, but I will take that up with God in my prayers, and I'll pray about it at night. But I just feel like, you know, sometimes, yes, I've rolled my eyes about something somebody posted that I didn't agree with, or I was like, oh, please, when people post stuff and you know they're a hot mess. I'm a hot mess, too. They don't call me the Hot Mess Express for nothing, ladies. I admit it. It's all right. We're all just living. We're trying to do our best. You learn every day, you know, and, you know, do I gossip with my girlfriends? Yes, I gossip. And do I think that that's okay? Not really. No, I don't think it's okay, but we all do it. We're all human, you know, but you will never, ever in your life catch me being negative on someone else's post because I just love when I see other people winning at their life. And you know, if they need a high five, I want to give them a high five. If they need a hug, I'll be there to give them a hug, even with the Rona. If you want a hug, you're getting it. I just think that, you know, you can take your negative energy and go elsewhere because it just has no home here. And I just really think it's just unnecessary. And I just was like I said in my post, when I feel like Facebook has gotten me into a negative mindset, I always turn to Pinterest. I love Pinterest. And I go on there and I will look up scripture and I will look up positive, funny quotes, memes, something just to get my mojo back on the right track. And I just, I thought, it's kind of sad that I have to do that, because really, if you're on Facebook, shouldn't you be on there to be supportive of someone? Everybody has haters and you can hate on somebody, but do that internally. Don't project it onto them and make them feel worse about themselves. And I'm not saying we can't disagree, because I have been enlightened many times in my life by someone who had a different view than I had. And do I change my thoughts to conform to theirs? Not always, never usually, but I appreciate the fact that they have their own opinions. And look, I'm going off. I'm sorry, guys, because I came on here to do makeup. So I'm going to get back. I'm going to get back to that. I always get sidetracked. Liquid eyeliner is what I used to use, but I am loving these extra lash eyeliners. They just are so smooth. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put my eyeliner on, and I really have to use my, I have a mirror sitting here that I have to use for this. I don't know how people do their mascara and their eyeliner on this. And we all know it isn't one of my videos if my dogs don't bark. Or my kids don't dance around. Toby, what's the matter? It's all right. So then that, like that. So I don't do a ton with my eyeliner. I like to start right here where my lashes get thick and go out and then do a thicker towards the end. That's just sort of my version of the cat eye, because I, like I said, I can't do any kind of winged anything. So that's that eye, which I think that I really like that. The Iconic palette, I really love the glam up, but the Iconic palette is just so beautiful too. Thank you, Cindy. Hi, Yvonne. How are you? I hope you're relaxing today with your people, all your handsome men. They were so cute on your video this morning. So I'm also going to, since I said we were getting more dolled up today, I'm going to use the double lash extend, because if I'm going somewhere and I want to get bougied up or dolled up, this is where I'm headed with that. So, all good, Yvonne. So, I watched some of my videos back on the replay just to kind of watch and, you know, judge myself and say maybe I shouldn't do that next time. Or I always think to myself, girl, you get off on a tangent, which I did again today. But whatever, it's me. That's what I do. So, you won't only hear about makeup on my videos. You're going to hear about whatever else. But I notice on my videos when I do mascara, I like whip really fast through these lashes, and other people are just like all like calm. I don't know. Maybe I'm not a calm person, but I'm going to try, because maybe I should do it a little slower and they would get coated better. I don't know. But I just have to say that this double lash extend is amazing, and I love it because it really gets to coating these lashes. And then when you use the other wand, it really lengthens and it separates. And it's so funny because so I have to just tell this little story, because I don't, my aunt Maria, I don't know if she watches these videos or not. I'm going to have to ask her. But, when I was a kid and I would watch her do her makeup, because I love and adore her, and I always have. But I She used to separate her eyelashes with a safety pin. And I used to always be like, oh my goodness. I used to think when I was a kid, like, how in the world does she do that and not poke her eye out? I still to this day don't know how she does it, because as an adult, I don't have a steady enough hand that I could even remotely do that. But this will separate your lashes. Sorry if I called you out on here, Aunt Maria. But this will separate your lashes without the risk of a safety pin near your eye. Are you on here, Aunt Maria? Did you just laugh? I never can tell who's watching if you don't comment sometimes. Kayla, I do love the Zen too. One of our challenges this week is to pick our favorite mascara, and your girl is struggling with that decision because I really love them all for different reasons and for different days. You know, I really do. I have a love for all of them. And I always slop it somewhere. It is not a day if I don't slop it. Maybe that's because I moved too quickly, like I said. I don't know. That's what you love, Yvonne? My shenanigans? Guys, I love me some Usher. I know I've said that in a previous video, but mm-mm-mm. Come on. I love me some Usher. Okay, so on to the lips, because I have my lipsticks on my desk, just, and these are like candles, like they had candles in them, and when the candle was gone, I just clean them out and use them, because they're, you know, something I already have that I would throw away. Aunt Maria, you just knew I was going to bring it up. please don't try that at home, ladies, she says. I was always amazed, though, at her for even doing that. But yeah, I for sure would never have tried it at home. Anyway, so I have my lipsticks like this. And I sat here one day, and these two lipsticks that I would never in my life think to put together were next to each other in my little container here. And I was like, oh, they kind of reflected weirdly in the light off of each other, I guess, maybe. I don't know. Aunt Maria, thank you for watching. I'm going to put them on together. Because I had these on in my profile picture, and I can't tell you how many people commented on it. I think partly because I was wearing a gloss, that I don't normally wear a gloss. Because, like I said, I feel like when I wear a gloss, it's like, bam, lips. And my lips are big already, and when I enhance them with gloss, it's like, whew, those are some lips. But I am going to do it. So I am going to use the Liquid Matte Lip in Confident. And I have to admit, guys, I am not, I think with my skin tone, Confident is not, it's not one of my favorites on its own. It's just not. And I don't dislike it, but on my skin tone and on my lips, it's a little too purple for my liking. But it looked amazing the way I did it the other day. Oh, Aunt Maria, you would like the double lash extend, I think. I can't imagine someone not liking it. And I don't use it every day. I definitely use it as a more bougie mascara. Not that you couldn't use it every day, but look at these lashes. Is This music is making me want to go out and hit the clubs. Okay, so that is Confident. The liquid matte lip in Confident. So, Aunt Jessica, it's pretty. I mean, I do not hate this. I think that is beautiful. But I tend to not wear it on its own. I usually will add some kind of lip liner to this because we all know your girl is a lip liner. And I didn't put any on today because I really want you guys to see this combination. So that was the Confident liquid matte lip. And like I said, these just so happened to be happy accident sitting next to each other in my little container here. And I thought let's try them together. So this is one of the glosses and it's called Nude Flirt. And now I will say, putting a gloss on top of the liquid matte lip, this liquid matte lip is not gonna stay. They don't. If I would leave this like this, this would stay all day. But if you add something to it, I think, like, even if I've put my lip conditioner under it, or if you put a gloss on top of it, or even when I put my lip liners under it, they are not as long lasting as they are just like this by themselves on their own. So that's just a little disclaimer. Not that there's anything wrong with that. You just have to reapply. But this is the Nude Flirt Gloss. Look how pretty that is together. It's more up my alley. Like, the color is definitely more right up my alley. Anyway, so that's that. I think, Kelly, these colors together are amazing. I can't get over how much I liked it. And like I said, I was really just like playing around because I have tons of the gloss, which I do love. I don't wear it that often because I'm a matte lip girl. But I was like, oh, let me try some of these glosses. And so they were just sitting next to each other. And I was like, I'm going to slap those on together. And they looked so pretty. Thank you, Yvonne. Anyway, guys, that was it. Like I said, I was going to try to do a little bit more of a bougie look today. And I don't know. Like I said, I ain't mad at this hair, but I feel like a Southern girl with this hair. Like it's big, big Southern hair. Thank you, Kayla. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today and listening to my rant. You know, because I gotta do it, right? Hey, Sonia, how are you? I can clean up, right? I know I come to work looking a hot ass mess, but I can look a little nicer. Sonia, I hope you're enjoying your Sunday. Thank you, Krista. That's really all I had, guys. I appreciate you tuning in and, like I said, listening to my rant and always tuning in and, you know, supporting me. I really, really do appreciate it. And I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Take care. I love you all.